Let's start with a very beginning. When you were a child, actually, when you had 13 years old, when you saw Antonin Panenka scoring that most famous penalty and winning the first and last major trophy in the history of Czechoslovakia, what do you remember about this day?
You know, I see that in the TV, I was very happy, and I am proud of the Panenka. I am good friend with him, and he's my big friend. We make any time together in Czech Republic, and this really nice person, and not just great player, but also about the people, is very nice person.
So we shall consider it as your first ever good memory with the football?
No, I seen the football in the TV before also, of course, not in 15 years. I start in the 7 years, I watched any game before in the TV, but Panenka, of course, it's my idol. Everybody was like him in the Czech Republic, of course. Was the biggest player in this moment, that he makes something what nobody make before him, you know, but the penalty what he make, it was something new, and really not easy in the final last penalty, and he make this, it was fantastic.
And it was versus Germany, the same opponent you will face later on in the World Cup 1990 in the quarterfinal. You were the captain. Do you consider it your biggest achievement as a footballer?
No, you know, the World Cup, you not play too much in your life. I play only one time the World Cup in the 90, and was of course the best souvenir in my career, after best memory, and what I think it was the more beautiful moment in not only my career, but I think it's also other player in Czechoslovakia, the Czechoslovakia national team.
So do you think that the referee in that game against Germany was a little bit harsh against your team?
You know what, I don't like speak about the referee, but
even after 50 years.
Yeah, after 13, and it's 30 years, but I have before 1 week also same problem here, and against the UIA, that it's I don't like speak about the referee.
Okay, let's skip this question. Well, let's pass to your managerial career later on. You started with your club of your life, Sparta Prague. There you worked with the little Mozart, Tomasz Rusecki. And I think it was a fun for you as a coach to have such an amazing player like him, no?
Yeah, that's... This was the player I chose him from the youth team. I going to the youth team for watch the Tomasz Rosicki, how he playing with the under 17, and after I decided he come to the first team with us, and I decided him for playing the starting member, and 18 years he play starting member in Champions League in Europe. He make very good game, very good career, only was many time injury, but he was the player. He makes spectators for the he play for the spectators.
Well, I was searching about your spell in Strasbourg, and I noticed something a little bit weird, that José Luis Chilaver didn't score a single goal while you were there as a coach. I don't know if you didn't allow him to shoot the penalty kicks and the free kicks or what.
Chilaver, yeah, he scored. He scored the penalty, yes, but I told him anytime I have good relationship. When he don't score the first penalty, after he didn't go to the shoot the penalty, but he scored any penalty, was not problem. But for free kick was not allowed. That's, you know, this is coming in France very fast. This is coming counter attack. It's very dangerous that he didn't shoot. But he was the great player, and it was pleasure for me the coaching this guy. Really
great. When later in Saint-Étienne, you were the coach who pushed Bafétimbi Gomez to the right track, and he never stopped scoring goals since then. Actually, he won the Asian Champions League like 2 hours ago with your club, El Hilal.
I see he made the pass, and I'm in contact with him. I make congratulations to him, and this really also the great player, and he's starting with me in Saint-Étienne, also with Pascal Feindouno, also the great player. That he was the really the young, and after he made big career, but why? He worked very hard in the training. After training, he went working every time a little more for finishing, and that it's now 35, 36 years, but he's playing the high level, and it's about he worked very hard. He's a very serious professional guy, and I wish him good luck more, maybe for some season more. And it's great what he make today. He win also the Champions League in Asia. It's a great trophy.
Okay, let's move on to another player from your spell in Emirates with Al Ahly. And I think he's the only Egyptian player you worked with during your career, which is Hosni Abdurabbo, the central midfielder, the Egyptian central midfielder, who is, for me is a complete central midfielder. But do you think he was capable of making it in Europe?
Yes, I think he was player for Europe. He was completely player with he know everything. He know defense, he know attack, he know score the goal. He was complete player. He know anything, but he was a good player. And for also with him, we won the title in UAE. We won the cup and the Super Cup. That is the player for the leader, good leader and great player.
How was the experience of being a president of the federation and the coach of the national team at the same time?
No, I think only the coach about we have some problem. We need to finish good the qualification for the World Cup. We have no chance for going to the World Cup, and in this moment we don't have the coach what we want. That the federation he say for you, I go for 6 game or 5 game. Was also good experience for me.
You didn't lose a single game, bro.
I didn't lose, but you know, for only temporary, it was not for long term. I know I go only for finish this. I decide alone for not for long term, but I go only for 5 game for finish the qualification to the World Cup.
Do you consider yourself more as a coach or as a man of a federation?
No, I want help for, I'm going back to the Czech Republic. I want working a little in the federation for help the football. The Czech Republic have too much problem that many people ask me for coming back for this job. But I prefer stay in the field and the working about the coaches. I not like stay in the office.
Okay. Okay, let's talk about Lebanon and 2 defeats this month. One versus Iran, the other versus Emirates. But the game against Iran, it broke our hearts, literally. How did you react on the sideline during the last 4 minutes and after the game at the dressing room as a coach?
You know, for me, it's important that if every player, he make in the game everything. And he play and he fight and he play with great desperate spirit. Together about the team, what I say, I spoke to the player, I say, thank you guys, you make a great job. Last 5 minutes was difficult, but everybody after the game, he know he played a very good game against the big team of Iran. And he was not lucky in the final. We lose maybe concentration, little power in the final of the game. We have 3 players. He need go out about injury. Difficult for every coach in the world when he lose last 5 minutes in the game. But we want probably working directly after the game for coming the player head up for really he make good game for that. And I say every player thank you for this good game. We try now play the football for beat everybody. But if we don't go to World Cup, we need now we have the big game. We have more one time Iran, South Korea. You and Syria and Iraq. This 4 game very very important for us. That we have the Arab Cup for possibility preparation for these 4 games. For us, it's really important fighting for going to set position to the group or qualify to the World Cup. We have chance.
Okay. You went to Lebanon during a crisis, economic, social, and political crisis. With the Beirut explosion last year and the pandemic, it's not easy situation for you, I guess.
Yeah, Lebanon have many problems, of course. But when you come here, you like the Lebanon, you like the Beirut, you like the life here and the people. And I understand every player how he fight for his country. You know, maybe somebody don't live here and not coming too much here. But when you come here, you feel something interesting. That it's for me in the Lebanon life. It's I adapt very fast for that, and I am happy here. I have group of the player, and it's, I every time. I would quickly for coming the next game for we training together. We have good group and we have good pleasure together.
Speaking about the Arab Cup, how do you see that group with Egypt, Algeria and Sudan? Are you going to fight, hoping to pass through the group stage? Or you prefer thinking about next games and World Cup qualifications?
You know that we want to every game, I spoke player, we want, and we have the spirit for we try to win every game. That it's not, of course, we have the in the group, maybe more difficult group, the Egypt and Algeria is the two maybe big favorite of Arab Cup. He won't win the Arab Cup, and he have big potential, great team, great player. That is not easy, but everything is possible in the football. That we prepare for make a good preparation now. Some days we have 1 week, 10 days for before, and we fight together for make the best result possible.
Is it true that you had a virtual meeting with Zamalek, the Egyptian club board, to take over the team last year?
Yeah, we spoke together last year with some people from committee, and finally he chose somebody other.
But you were willing to come to Egypt to take the job?
Yes, Zamalek, yes. It's a great team. Zamalek, Al Ahly, you know, this is the two biggest team. Pyramids now also coming, and Al-Ahli is of course a big favorite, but Zamalek every time is behind. But these two teams have chance for win the Champions League in Africa, and have very good player, and really the strong league in the Egypt, and the quality very good, and the support and everything is a good league.
Okay, last question. As a national team coach, you are obligated to vote for the FIFA awards, the best. Who is gonna be your number one choice, the best player?
You know, I didn't choose in this moment. I have more time for 2 weeks, but I think I didn't. This, I have Mohamed Salah also, of course, one of the best. Maybe sure is in first or second, but I didn't choose in this moment. I need more time, little for I watch now the game, everything. But you have reason, the Mohamed Salah is a big favorite also for that. He make good season as a great player, and today I make it not official, but in my head, and I think Mohamed Salah, it's one of the biggest favorite also for me.
It will be a great favor for us if you vote for Mohamed Salah.
Yeah, but he make really not only this season, he's the very good player. I like him also how he play. And today I make in my office in the federation for that, and I thinking yes, possible, it's possible. I think when I make to